The Paying Guest is set in London in 1922. Most of the action takes place in a suburban house owned by a middle-class mother and daughter who, because they've lost money, have had to bring in lodgers into the house. And they are a young married couple, a lower middle-class couple, Lillian and Leonard. And they move in, bringing at first irritations, as all the families have to kind of share space, but increasingly bringing excitement and then danger. So the novel is a story of forbidden passion and crime and guilt and responsibility, ultimately. The story of this novel is a very dramatic one. I mean, some quite nightmarish things happen to the characters, but it's very much a domestic story. You know, it's most of the action takes place in this suburban house, and I was very interested, I suppose, in how sometimes in life, they, ordinary people, are kind of their lives are plunged into nightmare and melodrama by the committing of a crime, for example. I looked at some high-profile murder cases from the 1920s and the 1930s in the UK, and some of those stories were part of the inspiration for The Paying Guests. The Paying Guest is set in the early 20s, and it's a period I hadn't written about before. You know, all my novels have been historical, but so far I've written novels set in the 19th century and then in the 1940s, and so I realised I didn't know much about what came between them. So I went to the 20s really not knowing much about it, quite unusually for me. I usually have an impression of a decade before I go there, but with this I didn't, and I began to research the period, and became really fascinated by it, especially by the early part of the 20s, because it was still so much in the shadow of the First World War, for one thing. You know, I think our clichés of the 20s are of kind of flappers and dancing and everybody having a kind of gay old time, but actually in the early part of the decade it was a very tense period. It was a period actually not unlike our own, in that there was lots of political unrest. There were lots of grievances between men who'd come back from the war, and the women who had actually made some gains in their absence. There was conflict between the generations. So I quite liked London was a bit of was tense in this period. And it was a time of great changes, and so the action that takes place within the confines of this suburban house very much for me reflects this sort of larger unrest in the world around it. And I'm genuinely interested in the past for its own sake. I'm interested in what makes the past different from the present. I'm interested in British social history, so I suppose I see my novels as kind of a reflection, really, on social history. I use the novels to think about the way in which people lived their ordinary lives, the way they shared domestic space, the way they felt about themselves, about their bodies, the way, you know, the differences between men and women, between the classes. You don't have to go back very far into history before all those things start looking quite foreign. And I think it's that foreignness that really stimulates me as a novelist.